Muy interesante. Gracias, amigos. Mr. Marston, how the devil are you?
I'm fine. How are you, Mr. Ricketts?
I'm good. I'm glad you're here because these men were just telling me about Mr. Escuela.
Javier Escuela?
Emilio, let me ask you something. His nombre is Javier, Señor Escuela? Is Javier, to see?
No sé, señor.
He doesn't know.
I got that bit. Ask him, was he about 5'8"? Mustache? Did he have an American in tow? A big American?
Emilio, estaba con, grande americano?
Yo no sé.
No.
Again, I got that.
But they do have his sister. Emilio's, I mean. She's a fine young woman. A teacher. A human being. Not the clothed vermin so many people seem to have turned into.
Tell him I'm sorry.
When a man's family is involved, you need a little more enthusiasm than mere apologies.
I have enough worries, sir. This man's problems pain me, but they're not quite my own.
Those who sit on the fence make a choice, in their own way. Don't you think, Mr. Marston?
Of course. And what about you, Ricketts? A man living in the past? A man who ran away from home? What choice did you make?
I'll tell you what choice I made. I'm a fighter, sir, and I'll fight to the end. I think we should get going. I'm gonna take the train. You can come with me or ride ahead to El Matadero.
Uno debe guardar a sus hermanas cuando Allende está cerca. ¿Cómo está usted?
I've been hearing some things about you, John Marston.
Really?
That perhaps you're more in need of my help than I thought.
Is that so?
That some recent encounters with this Bill Williamson fella haven't gone exactly in your favor.
Funny how everyone seems to know my business, but nothing about the men I'm looking for.
It isn't easy getting the locals to talk. It's the only way to travel, so they keep telling me. We'll get off at Casa Madrugada and ride from there. There should be some horses for us across the way. All right, let's head to El Matadero and see what they know about Luisa. We need to find a man called Carlos. I was told he could help us. We'll ask around when we get there. But we don't want to draw attention. See if you can keep your gun holstered for once.
You're the hero around here, Mr. Ricketts. Not me. What does the army want with this Luisa girl anyway?
She's a rebel, and apparently close to their leader, Reyes. She's a pretty young thing. That's normally reason enough for Allende.
So I've heard.
She's a good woman, a teacher. If they lay a finger on her, I swear I'll feed those bastards their balls. Here we are. Looks kind of sleepy, don't it? Easy now. All right, let's find this Carlos guy. Carlos.
Si.
We're here for Luisa. She's still being held up in the caves?
Yes. She's still up there. Who's the cowboy?
We're here to help.
Muy bien. I can distract the guards. You and the gringo can get inside.
Let's do it.
I will keep them talking, senor. The rest I will leave to you.
All right, let's find Luisa.
¡No puedes estar aquí!
Hace calor hoy. Bien bochornoso, ¿verdad?
¡No lo voy a decir otra vez! ¡No puedes estar aquí!
Oye, soy yo, Carlos. Pues trabajo en el matadero.
No me importa quién eres. Esta es una zona militar prohibida. Vete a casa.
Me gustan sus botas. Muy bonitas. Mi hermana tiene las mismas.
¡Pinche campesino de mierda! ¡Te voy a colgar al lado de tu cerdo!
¡Váyanse al infierno, traidores!
That's our cue. The entrance is down this way. You animals, she's just a girl!
Try shooting with your eyes open!
This way. Keep it, Marston. Come on, stay with me. If you've laid a finger on her, follow me. Must be in here. I'm gonna see if I can blow the door open. You keep guard. There'll be more on the way.
Aurelio?
Deal with those bastards, Marston.
Do you want to die?
Get behind the table. I'm gonna blow it.
Stand back, damn it! Here goes. Come on, boy. Poor girl's barely alive. Right, let's see if we can all get out of here in one piece. Looks like Carlos left us some horses. Come on! Whoa there. Let's go before any more of them show up. Meeting us here. Where is he? Something doesn't feel right here. Whoa! There he is. Talk about cutting it fine.
Luisa! Gracias a Dios.
Thank you for saving me. You're a good man. Friends of the people of this land.
Was someone named Harvey Gasquela one of the men holding you?
No. I don't know. I don't think so. But I remember that name from prison. Bad people spoke of him.
I told you, John, he's still in Mexico.
Okay, then. I guess we'll keep looking.
Yep.
Thank you.
Por unos pesos podemos retirar a mi cuarto y conocernos mejor, ¿eh?
No me toques.
Ay, Paul. No tengo nada.
Paul. Gentlemen, gentlemen, I thank you. Oh, yeah. Hey, Mr. Marston. How you keeping, sir?
Just fine, thank you. And you?
Oh, very well, sir. Thank God my wife died. Unlucky in love, lucky in cars. Corazon, champagne for everyone.
Keep playing, Mr. Ricketts.
Oh, I'm sorry, Herr Muller. I'll keep playing you in servitude for the rest of your life on Earth, if that makes you happy. Yes, I shall indeed, sir.
Well, then, your deal.
Oh, Marston, would you like to join us?
I don't think so. I'm just going to have a drink.
Oh, come on. Sit down. Sit down.
Okay, then. Gentlemen, hey.
Namakshon! Another American. Now I need two pairs of eyes.
Muller, we might have to send you off prospecting for more silver soon.
I fault.
Nothing like a game of poker to warm the soul. Now, I'll fold. I just ain't getting the cards. Look at that. A little beginner's luck.
I always enjoy taking an American's money.
Always a pleasure playing with you, Mr. Muller. I call you.
Uh-huh. I call. That's better.
I'll call.
I'll call.
Lady Luck is sure kicking my ass today. No, thank you.
Not for me. Both as lucky as he... You fucking cheat!
Excuse me?
You fucking looked in my fucking cards, you fucking cheat!
Now, Herr Muller, let's calm down. There must be some mistake.
There's no mistake. Your Yankee friend here is a fucking cheat.
Easy there, Germany. Calm yourself down.
Oh, yeah, you know exactly what you did.
Yeah, I know exactly what I did, friend, which was nothing. Now, I'd prefer it if we could all play a friendly game and no one get hurt.
You planted this guy, Ricketts.
Now, why would I do that? I've already beaten you. Now, calm down and let's finish the game.
There's no more cards game.
Ease up there, friend.
There must be a name for this.
An impasse, sir. An impasse. We could all die here.
I'm not fighting you, Ricketts, but the Yankee him I don't like.
He's done you no harm, Muller.
He's done me no good either. Outside, winner takes the pot.
The winner will take what he wants. The other man will be in no position to argue.
Sanchez will be my second.
As you wish, Germany. As you wish.
Walk with me, John. I want to make sure you know how this is going to work. A duel is all about timing. If you pull your gun too soon, you'll be less accurate. After you draw, pick your shots carefully, like I showed you. Once you've picked your marks, the rest, my friend, is in the hands of fate.
Come on, Yankee! I'm a busy man.
Steady now, partner. Stay calm.
You should have stayed home, Yankee.
Did play his cards too early. Come on, we've earned ourselves a drink. I think Mr. Muller's buying.
Your health.
You, the man they call Marston, see? You like killing? Watch me cut her throat.
Nice friends you got here, Mr. Ricketts.
Do you, Marston? Peleamos ahora, eh? We fight now.
Better not miss, partner.
No, por favor. Ayúdame, alguien.
And I know that girl.
No merezco esto. No puede ser.
Enjoy a drink in peace. Come on, smoke these bastards up. There he is. I've had it with that.
Fuera, cabrón.
Stay away from the Well, partner, I think we can safely save this poker game. Well, I must say, you tourists certainly bring peace and prosperity to this land. Then again, I doubt Muller will be missed.
He wasn't much of a poker player.
Hey, gringo.
Mr. Ricketts.
Come on in. Sit down and have yourself a drink.
Sure. Say, any word of Javier Escuela?
No, nothing yet. Say, why are you after him anyway?
We're old friends. We was kind of educated together.
So what is this, some kind of high school reunion sort of thing?
Something like that. Well, you've killed people. You live the life.
That I have.
And I tried to stop. I mean, I don't know. I tried to go straight. I did. I left the gang after the gang left me. Left me to die after I'd been shot. They'd all gone crazy anyhow. Our old leader, fella you probably heard of. Anyway, he more or less lost his mind, went and shot a bunch of people unfair-like. I got shot in a robbery. They left me, and I left them.
Well, that's how it goes.
Already had me a woman. Got me a farm. Then I got me more trouble.
Sure.
Been sent to track down the men I used to run with. Track them, kill them.
Well, if you don't, someone else will. There's no escape. Look at me. I spent 25 years killing men. Look at me now. Sitting around here like some low-rent would-be messiah. We're relics. Come on, have yourself another drink and let's wallow in a little self-pity.
Sounds like a plan.
Your health.
Mr. Ricketts! Mr. Ricketts! Thank the Lord I have found you. And you, Mr. Marston.
Will you sit down? You all right?
I'm well, sir. But Allende is sending more men to the death. Prisoners who have not been tried. A prominent writer, Castilla, and a local official whose only crime was not putting the small holders on the street when they were late with taxes.
Writers and government officials. For once, I agree with Allende. Some men need to be killed.
Mr. Ricketts!
I was just joking. Where are they?
Out near Escalera.
Let's hang up our self-pity and go shoot ourselves some bad guys. You're gonna be all right.
Thank you. Both of you.
¿Qué tal usted?
All right, here we go again.
¿Qué tal? Cobarde, hoy te mato. Igual a los demás.
No rush. I'm sure they'll hold the executions till we get there. Come on. Whoa there.
Luisa was pretty shaken up.
She's angry. This war is getting dirtier by the day. People are being executed for just having an opinion.
Allende seems to have more enemies by the day.
Perhaps you would know. Rumor has it you've been making all kinds of new friends.
I don't pay much attention to rumors.
Just be careful, John. Keep jumping from one side of the fence to the other. You might just get impaled on it.
I have to find these two men. With respect, how I do it is no concern of yours.
Choose your tone wisely, partner. Remember who you're talking to.
How could I ever forget?
And who are you, John Marston? Apart from a rat feeding every other hand he can find, my name means something. All you've done is kill a few peasants, and the only real outlaw you've taken on dropped you like a bad habit.
Now, I politely ask you to watch your tone, Ricketts.
All I'm saying is, maybe there's a reason why people around here don't want to talk. You must miss your family.
It's the only thing that keeps me going.
You know, you remind me a lot of myself. How I used to be. Stubborn and angry.
You ain't changed all that much.
I always thought I'd lived a charmed life. Look! It's an army convoy. I think I see the prisoners in those wagons. Come on!
This is getting real nasty.
Now, we'll handle it from here. I know you got other matters to attend to.
It's been nice riding with you, Mr. Ricketts.
And you too. You took me back to another time. Talk to Louisa. She'll help you, and she's well connected in that other land. I hope you find what you're looking for, Marston.
You know what I'm looking for.
If you say so, Marston. If you say so.
Where do you want to alight?
Escalera, please!
I don't mind if you sleep through this shift.
Take a nap.
What do you want, gringo? What are you doing here? Have you heard? There's a war going on.
My name's John Marston. I've been sent here to retrieve a couple of men. Can I speak to your commander?
You want to talk to my boss, gringo?
I guess.
Because I'm not good enough for you?
No, sir.
You think you're better than me? You come to my country, my poor little country, And you think you can be friends with the president?
No, sir. I'm sorry, sir. Things must have come out wrong. Maybe you can help me.
You'll be sorry, friend. Relax, Amir, relax.
Are you? Sure. Somewhere between a threatening stare and the soldier's arm to the teeth. Yeah. Yeah, you had me.
Welcome to Mexico, amigo! Let's come eat, drink, and then we'll talk. My name is Capitán Vicente de Santa.
John Marston.
My country is in pain, John Marston. Terrible pain. The rebels have seized the people by the throat and destroyed a way of life.
I'm no politician, sir.
And I am no soldier, tequila. But we are both beholding to our time. A brave man, perhaps you have heard of him. Coronel Allende. He's trying to preserve the order in our province. To keep our civilization alive. It is tough. The people are confused and usually swayed. Sometimes in the service of what is right, you gotta do terrible things. It breaks my heart.
I also am no moralist, sir.
I wish I enjoy your freedoms, Mr. Marston.
I'm trying to find a man, an American, an outlaw named Bill Williamson. I believe he came here to seek protection from another outlaw named Javier Escuela.
You're no moralist, but you hunt outlaws?
So it would seem. You heard anything of these men?
I am the government, or what is left of it. Outlaws seek each other. They're possibly hiding with thieves and killers who pose as freedom fighters in the hills around here. They're united under one traitor named Abraham.
Where could I find this Reyes?
If I knew, I would be there, hunting him with everything that is true within me. Reyes finds you.
Like cholera.
Something like that. But it's possible, though. My men are trying to lure him into a trap. Possibly, you could ride with us. And if everything goes okay, I'm sure the Coronel will help you.
Okay.
Vámonos! You can take your horse or ride on the wagon.
Arre, caballo, arre!
Ya, caballito, aquí nomás.
Mexican army, I can see.
I didn't know what to expect. I hadn't even crossed the border and I was being shot at.
You will hear a lot of words like tyrant and oppression here. Words that the peasants have been taught. But do not understand meaningless words. The army is suffering a crisis of reputation.
Even I've heard about the colonel.
It's not far now. Are you ready?
Ready for what?
We will lure the rebels into a trap. There's a train leaving to Parrosa soon. We're going to escort it. They will think it's a supply train. But there are no supplies on it.
Very clever.
We must throw the rats out of their holes. Give them some bait they can refuse. Come on! The train is waiting. What are you waiting for? On your horse!
You have to get to the train. Follow me.
Come on.
There is a train. We must escort it to Casa Madrugada.
Yeah.
Yeah! Aim at the rail! again, compadre. You did a good thing for Mexico today. Coronel Allende will be very pleased.
¡Los rebeldes están robando el tren!
¡Levántese, perezoso, que sepa que le estoy pagando!
Marston, you're gonna have to do something.
What?
You have to go out there and stop the train before it crosses the bridge.
Yeah.
¡Todavía levántese! Ay, ¡usted también! Y allá atrás, muévase! ¿Qué le pasa a usted? ¡Ay, oh, Dios mío, levántese! ¡Ya mismo!
God damn it!
Get your madre!
Busca un balazo, cabrón.
¿Eres llorón, maricón? ¡Me das asco! Hablas lealtad, pero eres transparente. Estarás aplaudiendo cuando mi cabeza está en pelado, ¿verdad?
No, mi excelencia. Mis hombres y yo estamos trabajando noche y día por su honor.
¿Honor? ¿Qué eres, un muchacho? Jovencito, sin vergüenza. ¿Qué diablo es este cabrón?
That's the man who helped us defeat Reyes. The man I spoke to you of. A friend of Mexico.
Hello, sir.
Hola, gringo. So you are the bounty hunter, huh? Have you found your prey yet?
No, sir.
Ah, perhaps you come to hunt me, huh? Your country loves to make trouble in mine.
Perhaps, but it isn't so.
Ah, perhaps I should tie you to a horse and let it drag you around town. Or let the dogs fight you, huh? Then see what you say.
I'd say the same thing. I'm here to bring two men to justice, nothing more. Your politics or ideas of entertainment are not my concern.
Yeah, I suppose not. Pero son tuyos. Sinceramente, espero que me encontraste alguna compañía más interesante que esa bruja que me traíste anoche.
Let me ask you this, sir. Do you know anything of the men I'm looking for?
Escuela is from this province. His father was a borracho, a drunk who worked as a laborer on land cultivated by my uncle. Men like that are natural allies for Reyes. My people have lived and worked here for 100 years. We brought civilization. And these people, these fucking monkeys, despise us. We brought them God! And they turned their back on him. Now I fight to help them from themselves, to save them from themselves. I see in their faces that they would kill me if they could. Is she only a tyrant? That is the way it is. These people need a ruler.
Well, sorry to hear that.
Sorry? Why be sorry? It is a way of mankind. A fight between two forces. Que será, será. What will be, will be. But I know one thing, Senor Marston. Force. Force must be used if you are to have your own way.
I'm sure.
Now, perhaps you can do me a favor while I find these men for you.
After we find the men, then I'll help in any way I can.
You are in no position to negotiate. Now, por favor, a bunch of these idiots men are fighting at Tesoro Azul. Now, you head there and you lend your support. Baboso, ¿cuántas veces voy a decirte? ¡No ponga detrás de mí! ¿Qué eres, cabrón? ¡No está mi sombra! ¡Vaya!
Follow me. We must hurry.
Let's go!
So I finally met your great leader. He certainly lives up to his reputation.
What would you know about leadership?
Only that most can't handle power.
This isn't to criticize power when you have never had it yourself. Maybe it is because you have never been in the presence of a strong man before. I have seen the pictures of your country in the newspapers. Men preening and decorating themselves like women. Vanity is the legacy the British left behind.
Look, I don't know the fella. Just saying, that's how he treats his own men.
Coronel Allende controls any situation he's in because he knows that situation can never be allowed to control him. It is what a leader must do. And in case you had not noticed, we're fighting a war. We're all under a lot of pressure.
Pressure to find young girls?
The Coronel needs recreation like everyone else. He does not have time to court women. He's waging a war on ignorance and is impatient for victory. He's trying to inspire wisdom in those more stupid than himself. We must hurry! You Americans think you can ride? Do you? Come on, I will race you there. Do you want me to slow down?
Let's go!
Come on! You can do better than that! My men are dead, the rebels will all die. If they're alive, they have failed me, and the rebels will all die.
So, I guess we ain't taking any prisoners then.
Traitors will be made to suffer, shown that we will not tolerate the rebellion any longer. Our animals, we will slaughter them accordingly.
Mierda! De Santa, ¿por qué tardaste tanto? ¿Y quién es este gringo?
Octavio, por favor, cada hombre ayuda.
I hope you fight better than this little girl, gringo. Come, let's have some fun.
Crying in that house over there. Remember, nobody takes them before Allende.
We did all this just to get women for Allende?
No, that's just a bonus. This village is riddled with rebels. Make sure they don't have homes to come back to. There are fire bottles over there. Use them to burn down some of these houses.
And what makes you think I'd do that?
You want to find Javier Escuela, don't you? John, you're helping Mexico.
Vámonos, muchachos! ¡Buen trabajo!
Yo me quedo aquí para vigilar el gringo, Capitán de Santa. Get the fire bottle! It is time to finish what we started! Por aquí, imbécil! ¿Por qué no me sigues? What are you waiting for? Burn it down! Go on! Burn it down to the ground! Venga! Let's do it quickly! I want to go home! Hurry! I do not want to be here any more than you do!
We're not leaving! Until you finish this!
Throw it, gringo! Stop wasting time!
Sorry about this!
Isn't that beautiful?
You really are pathetic.
You need to relax. Come back to the villa and sample some of the new girls before they spoil.